coach.
That's it.
With an engine on it.
Yeah.
And you're mainly up the front through the corridor with a coach. No, you're on the other end of that most of the time. Propeller.
Yeah. I've seen it go around quite a few times.
Yeah, I've done it through, a few weeks ago, actually. Came over to town from
Why are they filming on that?
Well, they do that for road burners.
Yeah.
They don't need to chat, you know, the sequence of the signals and all that.
Yeah. There's a lot of stuff going down to the harbour these days.
What do you mean? Quite a few planes over there.
Things like that are really worth getting into.
They come from all areas, don't they? Waterloo and Brighton, Barrington. Yeah, quite a few friends still in there.
Yeah.
Next year they're going to run trains from Bournemouth to Gatwick or
I don't know that.
Yeah, when the electrification's done, it runs trains from Portsmouth down to Gatwick.
Because I know that Gatwick route is being a bit of a problem now because they route everything that way now.
That's where the money is, see? That's where the money is. All these, you know, these places now, they... They've got people all the year round, aren't they, travelling, see?
Yeah.
People go have a lot of holidays in the winter months now, don't they? You know, go get away from the winter. Because that's where the money is.
Right, sorry.
So that's why because when this tunnel comes in, I suppose that'll be another part of the setup, you know, this channel tunnel, I suppose.
Yeah. Because I filmed a Horsham line the other day. I went through Dorking and the folks there were,
yeah.
I mean, that used to be the main route for Pompey, right?
Yeah.
But now everything goes through Gatwick.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, big money there, I think. And that's what they're hoping to do now, is to run them across this way to Gatwick. Got to borrow this netty right now.
Yeah.
Oh, God. quite nippy things in the, when they were thicker.
I met a bloke who's taken them down to Dungeness and New Romney when that was so pretty.
Oh, yeah.
There's been quite a few odd little things that never really were developed, you know, that should have been. Like the old 71s, do you remember?
Yeah.
This bloke reckoned he was taking them up to 125 miles an hour. No problem when they first came out. rails. Have there any rails on the side?
What?
Are there any rails around the side?
No.
Are there?
Yeah. I don't know if it goes all the way to the Reading, though. It goes as far as Eastleigh. There are some that go through.
Yeah, one of them. There are. We worked one for our carriage over one of the time. One of them we worked goes right through the Reading.
Yeah.
I think it's later in the evening.
Yeah.
Yeah, it gets up there about 4 to 8.
Yeah.
I think something like that. And he goes right through, comes back.
Well, the only one I could get now would be 6 o'clock at Basingstoke, by which time the light is a bit.
Yeah,
Salisbury, Exeter.
Oh, yeah.
No problem at all, you know.
Getting an hour away, it's beautiful. got plenty of doors to get in and out of.
Yeah.
These sprinters, you've only got the door each end and one in the middle.
That's right.
People are getting out, you can't get in. Hung up like that all the time.
Told you the earlier sprinters, the 150s, they had more doors, but even less comfortable, I thought.
Yeah, I've never got on them, but we've got some more coming out next year, all right, 158.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be 3-car a unit. It's supposed to be 90 miles an hour,
isn't
it?
Yeah.
I don't think they've even built them yet.
Portsmouth is in a similar state, you know, had the box this time last year.
I can never understand why they ever bothered to make these anyway in the port field. It was about 8 years ago, really.
Anything non-standard tends to get scrapped.
Yeah. And then all these designers run around somewhere with trying their engines. So they start to put a few. That's why the Western Ring has always had so many different types of locos. Because it's only to test their engines there. Well, they wanted to test their engines. They had to have somewhere to test their engines. So they put them on the railway. They never built one basic diesel, did they? They built loads of them.
Well, that's right. Well, they decided to standardise on a few of it too early, didn't they? Yeah.
You've got the situation where a bloke to drive a new one but didn't know another, you know. That used to cause the problem. But a basic diesel, whatever anybody could drive, half the problem would have been solved.
Yeah.
Thank you. they electrify here, and so the problem to be over here is dogs and kids.
Yeah.
It burnt.
That's right. So just like he's having a third rail there.
No. I mean, they're doing all the fences and that, but they always make holes in them somewhere.
Yeah, yeah. Very difficult job to do. Mind you, they could make things a lot easier by leaving less rubbish around the track.
Right.
Well, it's no wonder you get like sleepers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So that's a bit of trouble, especially with school holidays. Dirty. It's not too bad now, but when you start facing the sun,
yeah,
it really brings it out.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you think they designed a wind washer as well with these, wouldn't you? I mean, got them on the modern new ones, guys, but you have got them on the old stock.
Yeah.
But this one got a big mister. But a lot of them, the first ones we had, they never had big misters or nothing. We had a bad winter, like that. Break the ice off with a plastic spoon or something.
I suppose you never get to do the Wessex units, do you?
No.
No. Oh, you should hear what the drivers have to say down there. It's not complimentary, you know.
No.
I mean, you've probably heard it all, but I mean...
Well, they don't design them for our benefit.
No.
They're doing it for their own, don't they? You know?
Yeah.
Don't ask us anything about
the
song, just do it.
Well, that's what they were saying, you know. They're pointing out, like, the row of switches, like, tail light, other lights, and then the switch will go up from series to parallel amongst those, you know, fiddling around in the dark and it'll switch. Scraping really severe, and
it's a bit oily as well, you see.
I think you need that stuff and water, really.
Soap and water is the only thing that cleans that.
Yeah.
bit of acid or something.
That's the old Gosport line, isn't it?
Yeah.
How much of that is left?
Well, it goes down as far as Bedlam.
Yeah.
Ammunition dump there.
Oh, right.
Well, the ammunition from the whole Navy part of it. That's all, just all you get at Crawford, that is. Like all Crawford. Just came out before they shut that, they were the run things down there.
I'll say, yeah.
Shut up before this started, sorry. If you weren't laying there on the steam though, you know.
Yeah,
there used to
be a lot more lines down here, didn't there?
Well, they used to run, well, Gosport, all other than the Americans. Up through Wickham, Rockford, that way, though.
Yeah. Presumably when they've electrified this particular line, there'll be no need for these DEMUs at all, will
there? No, really, no.
Reading basic stuff, that's
better. They are using the engine itself and coating.
Yeah,
that's good. It's the same type of engine that you've got on the EDL, you know.
Yeah.
It's the same type of engine, too, but whether they got plans to use the engine or the coat the engine itself, you know, so I think they'll probably sell them off to some foreign country, you know.
Yeah.
You know, one of these poor countries that can't afford to buy new stuff. They'd get plenty of work out of these if they wouldn't. They'll get plenty of miles out of these. Ones.
Yeah, right. Unusual stop is really interesting to me. The other day I was up there doing Manchester Victorian Ferry Line.
Oh, yeah.
And there they've got third rail electrics that take power from the side of the third rail.
Oh,
no problem with any of the rubbish on top of the rail at all.
Right.
And it's really old. They've been there since
forever.
Well,
it's
like it. It's
bad weather and all.
Well, that's it, you see.
That is the problem with this type of rail. You get bad.
Yeah.
They just don't run there.
Well, that's right. Yeah.
They do run the, sort of film oil on the ground in the winter to stop any oil falling.
Yeah.
It's not always solve the problem. But the worst thing is that when it rains and it freezes.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it might be worth a while hanging on to a few of these.
Well, it's been that good for a little while.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't matter how bad the weather is, these units are always run.
Yeah.
Whereas everything comes to a stand, you can still tell them. So.
Yeah.
Oh, they're not very warm in the winter, I must say.
Oh, no,
it's pretty cold.
They are in the summer.
Hot.
Yeah.
Hot in the summer. Bloody horrible winter, isn't it? It's not getting very warm at all.
Regrettably, as the choir tends, you know. I mean,
yeah.
If I film it,
yeah,
you really want that noise, you know.
Yeah, the other end, you know.
Yeah. Said about the DMUs, weren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Mind you, they have got a lot less in numbers noticeably over the year.
They're really bad, some of them, weren't they? You know, they only had got the old bus engine, didn't they?
Well, that's right.
Old Leyland bus engines.
But the funny thing was, down in Cornwall, Are you
cracking? Yeah, cracking, yeah. the numbers down to 46 last night.
Yeah. So presumably you would have done that Horsham Road.
What?
You would have done that Horsham Road, didn't you?
I've been over there, not recent years, but we used to watch ballast trains, stunt trains and all that.
Yeah.
20 years ago, but don't go over there now. I'm in a link where you don't go over that road. Oh. The other links, they go that way still, Victoria and all that.
Yeah.
We go to Broy, and that's as far as you go over there. Most of our work's all the way to Cardiff.
Yeah.
Not many blokes left trained on these days.
So?
They've retired, you know, a lot of chaps have retired and they haven't brought the blokes along to be trained on them.
Gets any lower, you've got problems.
Well, so that's why they give us it.
Yeah,
when you get a sun on the island, you can't see nothing. Well, so it's in the car, isn't it? When I go back there, you're born to go back there and get the sun all the time.
Yeah. There was a branch going up somewhere on the left. Was that back there? We used to go
to there, the old station railway used to run there. The old platform's still over there, look.
Oh, I see, yeah.
The platform there.
Yeah.
There used to be the old station railway. Because that was gone, I think, on something on the road.
Yeah.
Have a road over the harbour that went straight over to the dockyard for the old safe jetty for the old roll to lodge and they should go for and put. That was still in Gowan Whilst. still here when I started.
To redoing this station, I thought we would have put an extra couple of lines in over here.
Just ain't got a room, I suppose.
Yeah.
You want to talk about shutting the harbour up altogether anyway?
Yeah. Well, that'd be silly, really.
Well, the trouble is, there's nothing to do with the boats now. They've sold out to sea length. So the boat. Getting people to the boats, there's no problem with the railway now, that's their problem.
Yeah.
There was talk about coming as far as there and that was their problem. It might come yet, a few years gone.
So yeah.
Just to bring it, make a dead end here and that's it. Because now there's somebody else bidding for the great funnel and sea link. Somebody sells eight to somebody else.
line that come up here somewhere.
Straight on.
Oh, yeah, because that signal box has got a funny angle, isn't it?
Yeah.